Hey guys, I want to talk about the survival group. Now, a lot of people talk about this issue and they talk about getting together with other preppers, and the whole idea is that we're preparing for an emergency, whether it be a natural disaster or economic collapse or whatever. Where we want to be better prepared if there's an emergency. We want to have certain tools, a certain knowledge to help us in a really bad emergency situation, especially if it's nationwide or community-wide, something really important. A lot of people, they figure they're not going to have access to basic resources, so why not provide their own resources or use their own knowledge to help their families in a crisis? And some people want to get together with other preppers and form other groups. Makes sense in a lot of ways. A lot of people, they want to bring their knowledge to this group, and everyone brings their own experience, their own skills to this group, and ideas. Once things go wrong, everybody comes together and they help one another. They meet up in a certain location and they help one another and possibly other people. Well, before you get into a situation like that, you have to ask yourself, what are your core values? What are the things you value most, and how would you handle really important situations in a crisis? For example, if you're in a group and you come across a child that seems abandoned, it seems like the child is alone, and the child, you're convinced that the child needs resources, the child needs help. How do you go about handling that situation? What would be the group's protocol for bringing in new people? How would other people within your group feel about that? If you guys can't come to a consensus on that, you may have an issue right there. Another issue, just bringing in new people in the group in general, that's a huge issue. Another issue, how do you distribute resources? How do you punish people? How do you reward people? Security, how do you handle security? What's the punishment for not doing what you're supposed to do? Things like that, these are really important things. And there has to be a certain level of trust. There has to be a certain set of values that you guys agree upon. Now, I'm not talking about politics or anything like that, but I'm talking about things that are relevant to actually surviving. Now, here's another aspect of the whole group, survival group thing. It may not be, your survival group may not be the people that you choose. It just may be the people that survives. By that I mean, you could prepare perfectly, it seems. You can have just about everything done right, and one little mistake, or even no mistakes, there could be a virus that wipes out most of the population. Now, that's a pretty extreme scenario, but if something like that happens, you would essentially lose a lot of people who are close to you, a lot of people in your group, your friends, your family, and you may have to work with complete strangers in the aftermath of such an event and actually build upon that and actually try to survive as a group. Now, how do you go about trusting those people? Well, here's a question that may pop up in your head that may be helpful or may not. Here's a question. How did this person survive? How did this person survive? And that may be relevant to a lot of people. Did this person do a lot of wrongdoing? Obviously, nobody's perfect, but did this person hurt a great deal of people to survive? How is that going to affect your ability to work with that person? Does it matter at all? Maybe the only thing that really matters in your mind at that point, it may all be that, hey, as long as the person survives, we're all here, so let's work together. But of course, past behavior is the best predictor of future behavior, and if a person betrayed or their previous group or other people in their lives, and now they're in your group, now you got to worry about that. So that's when the past starts to matter. But then the whole event may be so traumatic that it may transform the person, if you believe that a person could actually change. So a survival group, is a survival group really going to be the group that you pick, or is it going to be the people that you're just stuck with, the people who actually survive? How would you go about approaching that? All you could really do as a prepper is do your very best, and that's what I'm trying to do. And I'm trying to get a discussion going right here on this channel. So guys, share your thoughts about that, And how would you decide whether you need to join a group or not? Maybe there may be other groups out there that pose a threat to your security, to your safety. Maybe you may feel like you need some help. So you may actually need somebody to help you out with a garden or help you out with certain resources, things that you can't do on your own. So it's something worth thinking about. Thank you guys. Please share your thoughts. Now, how would you go about getting involved in a survival group before or even after there's a major event? All right, guys. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.